Want to take some normal photos and make them spine-chillingly ready for Halloween? In this video, I'll demonstrate several spooky photo effects in PaintShop Pro. Before we get started, if you're watching this video on YouTube, you'll find a link in the description below that will take you to our tutorial page on Corel's Discovery Center. Here you can also download a written copy of this tutorial, along with the sample images you can download to try out the steps yourself. I'll start with this cheerful-looking jack-o'-lantern and make that smile look more maniacal. I have PaintShop Pro open in the Edit workspace. All of my photos for this video are in the same folder, so I'll use the organizer to find them. Clicking the navigation icon brings up my list of folders. I'll browse to the right folder, and here are the images in the organizer. I can double-click or drag this image to start editing. Then I'll click this push pin to minimize the organizer. First, I'll start with the easiest method, running a ready-made script. This script is part of our Fall Scripts collection. It can be purchased and downloaded from Corel's Discovery Center or from the Get More tab on PaintShop Pro's welcome screen. The Fall collection contains four scripts, and the one I'll use here is called Spooky Forest. All scripts can be run from the File, Script, Run menu, or you can display the script toolbar by choosing View, Toolbars, Script. I'll find Spooky Forest in the pull-down menu and simply click the Run icon. It takes just a few seconds to run through all of the steps in the script, and here is the creepy result. If you're the DIY type who would rather create your own effects, I'll now go through several more eerie examples. I'll close the jack-o'-lantern without saving and reopen it from the organizer. Before applying any effects, I'll right-click on this layer and duplicate it. Then I'll click the new layer's title and name it Spooky. As long as this layer is active, I won't be making any changes to the original image. I'll choose Effects, Photo Effects, Retro Lab. What I have now is a before and after view of the image. I want my area of focus to be a circle, so I'll click the circular selection tool and click and drag from the center to just outside the jack-o'-lantern. I can drag the circle to a different spot or resize the circle by dragging one of the small square handles. On the preview side, I now have a vignette of darkness outside the circle. To get a sense of the effects I can create, I can use the randomize parameters icon, clicking repeatedly to see all of the really weird ways to view this pumpkin. Then, when I'm ready to finalize the effect, I can use these four sliders to adjust the darkness, blur, or feather outside the circle, or the glow inside. Where it gets really fun is the color adjust. Moving the hue to about negative 20 produces a sinister red. I can increase the color intensity by increasing the saturation. I can also add more magenta and yellow for even more intensity. When I'm finished, I'll click OK. And I can go back to my original harmless jack-o'-lantern by turning off the spooky layer. For another retro lab effect, I'll duplicate the original layer once again and name the new layer green. I want to relaunch the retro lab, and another place where I can access this is through the Learning Center, which can be opened in the Palettes menu or by pressing F10. I'll choose Effects, then Retro Lab. I'll bring these four sliders down and increase the circle size to include more of the background. Then I'll slide the hue to about 65 to bring out more green, and I'll increase the green down here as well. The other two color sliders should be close to the middle. Now it appears that the gruesome green is creeping into the background. Next, I'll take this image of a full moon and turn it into a creepy blood moon. Before applying any color effects, I first want to increase the contrast between the moon's surface and shadows. So I'll go to Adjust, Smart Photo Fix, where again I have a before and after preview. I'll bring down the overall brightness, increase the saturation to bring out more color, and I'll increase the focus to sharpen the shadows. Now I'll click OK, and I'm ready to bring back the Retro Lab. I'll adjust the circle from where it was in the previous image. I'll move these three color sliders back to about the center and set the hue to negative 50, which is a deep red. I'll set the saturation to wash out the color a bit. Then I'll increase the red here, the green here, and the yellow here. I'll also reduce the dark light range, remove any blur, and increase the diffuse glow and feather edge. I'll press OK to see the result. A full moon you wouldn't want to encounter while walking alone down a dark street. The next image is a mansion that would look great on a real estate website, but with a few clicks, can be made to appear downright haunted. I'll choose Effects, Photo Effects, Infrared Film. I have Preview on Image checked so I can see my adjustments in real time. I can play with the randomized parameters here, or set the strength, flare, and grain to make the house appear like it's the site of a séance. But since the overall appearance is still a bit too bright, I'll use Adjust, Hue and Saturation, Hue Saturation Lightness, and Decrease the Lightness. I can also go back to the Retro Lab, using a rectangular selection, and with low saturation and some other adjustments, this mansion can look even scarier. For my last creepy example, I'll take this skull and make it even freakier. I'll start with some instant effects, which can be found in the Instant Effects palette. The one I want to apply first is in the landscape effects, and I'll double-click on Contrast More. Then from the retro effects, I'll double-click Retro Dark. My skull is certainly scary, but looks a little too purple. So I'll close Instant Effects, then choose Adjust, Hue and Saturation, Colorize. For a glowing yellow effect, I'll bring the hue to about 30 and increase the saturation. For a lightning after effect, I'll click the Picture Tube tool. I'll click this icon in the interactive property bar to choose the picture I want to randomly apply, which in this case will be lightning. I'm using random placement and random selection, increasing the scale, and clicking in various spots on the image to add some lightning bolts. This brings us to the end of this tutorial on spooky photo effects. If you've been watching this video on YouTube, please follow the link in the description below, which will take you to this tutorial page in Corel's Discovery Center. Here you'll find a written version of this tutorial, along with the sample images you can download and follow along.